Hello, good evening from my side. My name is Katarina Lucic and I'm a program designer and program manager at the VU Executive Academy. We have a new program called Program Data Science. Professor Polaris is our academic director and we will tell you a bit what the VU offers in the field of data science. Before I hand over again to Axel Polaris, I will say a few words about the Vienna University of Economics and Businesses. First of all, I would like to say something about the campus. I think the most of you know the new campus of the Vienna University of Economics and Businesses. We moved in 2013, and we have some buildings of very famous and international architects like Zaha Hadid and Sir Peter Cook. The learning center is from Zaha Hadid, I think the most of you know it. And since 2013, also the VU Executive Academy has its own building, as the demand on executive education is growing. But our campus is, here are some facts and figures about the Vienna University of Economics and Businesses, the total building costs. This is why the Vienna University of Economics and Businesses is also very open-minded. You can also always go into the learning parts in the buildings, not in the offices, but all the other rooms. Yeah, the VU is not just visually attractive, but also has the highest quality of education, teaching, and research. We are triple crown accredited. Only few institutes in the world are like this triple accredited. We are also listed in the Financial Times ranking and have one of the best and top MBA in the world. Yeah, the VU offers bachelor's and master degrees and various competence centers. And as a fourth column, we have the VU Executive Academy. The VU Executive Academy is focusing on the whole executive education. I will give you just a brief overview, as I think Professor Polaris will also go deeper into the data science part. We have MBAs, of course, and law programs. The global MBA is very known, and also the professional MBA. And when you do our data science program, you can upgrade the ECTS, you can take it and upgrade it to a PMBA. We have certificate programs. The oldest one is even 70 years old, tourism and event management. Yeah, on logistics marketing, there are a lot of certificate programs. We have short programs. These are like programs about 5 to 12 days over a few months, and also with blended learning. And you can actually take such a course for a few months and be a little bit better in some of these topics. The new ones that we started this autumn are Pioneers of the 21st Century. It's a leadership program and data science. And then we have as well, last but not least, the custom programs. They are really tailor programs for companies and organizations. From a 2 hours input to up to a 2 years in-house MBA. So if you in your company say we really want to have a specialization in our company on data science, we can tailor such a program for you and your organization. Yeah, this is it from my side.
Okay. Thanks for the introduction of general what we do at VU on education. So what I wanted to start with was telling you a bit of where we're coming from. So I could actually look back in the slides. You see here several things. You see we have this executive academy program, but we are also, of course, our main teaching focus is in all the teaching programs, in undergrad and graduate programs. And so that's where we started to put in data science education. So I was joining VU 2013 as a professor for data and knowledge engineering. Actually, my background is AI, but not machine learning, so more symbolic AI, where I come from, and I did a lot of research also in data processing, data integration for data from the web. And one of the things I wanted to get to the U in the teaching programs was websites and data science. And I'm proud that we can present this now, so what we already have achieved in getting these contents into our course programs. So the first thing we started with was in the winter semester 2016, so a bit more than a year ago, where we started the first batch of our undergrad specialization in data science. And you might ask yourself why you want to do that at the University of Economics and Business. So let's ask our students. So our students said that basically that's the companies they want to work with, allegedly. I don't know, I found this just on the Facebook channel of EU, which said that basically our top employers for our students would be Red Bull, BMW, Google, Apple, and the United Nations. So now, about all these companies are either already data-driven or they have basically been disrupted by data. So if you think about Google, obviously everybody believes that, but also Apple has changed from a hardware company to a data company, investing in data centers and having disruptive data, business models working on data. Red Bull as a marketing, so that's the point with marketing I was making, marketing has changed completely with data and data science, right? So we also have colleagues from marketing educating in our program, which could tell you more about that. Car manufacturers obviously use data in all kinds of areas, supply chain management, car-to-car communication technologies, intelligent production, etc. And all what you see there is basically that I could argue this probably for any discipline in that is affected by University of Economics. Last but not least, the United Nations is one of the biggest providers of open data, which is also one of the topics in our research. So I wrote my thoughts about this in a little article which we put in the OCJ journal, so the Austrian Computer Society journal. What I think what is new on the job title data scientist back then, so that was in 2015, and I'm curious for discussion whether we agree on that, but what I thought what is really the interesting thing is that there is scientist put in the title of a job description in companies. So that companies also realize that they need people with an investigative mindset and which basically have kind of a scientific approach, maybe even on the data problems which are overwhelming companies nowadays. So around these thoughts, there is more in the article, we put together an undergraduate program which we were fairly quick with. So we launched it, as I said, in 2016. And the idea is to have an interdisciplinary program, which is also having different institutes involved, like my institute for information business, production management, statistics and mathematics, of course, the Institute for New Media, but also law and marketing. So all courses are taught in English, and that's part of our undergrad program. So we have specializations in the undergrad programs, which are 5 courses. Where we teach people the basics. So what we want to do is we want to teach them data processing. So what I have to explain there maybe is that we don't have so many students with a computer science or technical background. We first have to get them to get your hands dirty and work with data. That's this course Data Processing 1. Then data analytics is where they learn basic machine learning, data mining techniques, and also more on statistics what they get in the basic courses. That's taught by our statisticians. Then we have a third course which is about large-scale data processing. So this is basically how you scale up those methods to bigger amounts of data, and we also teach on stream processing, for instance, there. But also as a part of that third course, so it's like 2 parts course, and that has administrative issues with things like that, but basically it has a first half and a second half, and the second half is about legal and ethical foundations of data science, which we find very important. This is also what we get, and I think you mentioned it already, as a request from companies. They want to learn about implications of new laws, like the General Data Protection Regulation. They want to know about ethical implications of dealing with data, etc. And that's what we want to get across there. The fourth course is applications, so that's also very important for us. Our approach to teach data science is on applications, and to teach knowledge which comes from particularly business domains. Like we have special courses on data science use cases in production management, supply chain management, marketing, process management, etc. So this is basically also something we can expand over the next few years and which we plan to do. Then the last course is what we call the Data Science Lab, where people work in groups and apply their skills together. So many people there actually have to learn in groups, and our approach, what we also think for data, what's important in data science is that nobody knows everything, and that people have to learn to work in teams on projects. And these projects and the problems come from companies and from practical use cases. So we have had here also, so this is just one set of partners which we had in the first iteration of this course, where we had projects from banks, from IT companies, but also from search and from the Zang, for instance. And we let our students work with data from these companies and basically develop some ideas. So that's also maybe something for you which could be interesting if you could bring in use cases which our students could work with, that would be very much appreciated in this program. Good. So that's how this runs. So what do we teach there? Obviously, language-wise, we teach Python and R. R is also very important for VU, as one of the members or some of the members of the R core development team are at VU. Kurtwanik, the professor at VU, for instance. And we want to teach the students to the willingness to work in teams, to solve data problems, to get their hands on data. And at the moment, we're quite successful. So we have 30 slots for this specialization, and typically have 2.5 to 3 times more interested students so far. And we hope this to continue this and stay popular with this group. So these specializations are going over 2 semesters. So what else we've developed is a program with the Executive Academy, which we started just recently. So it's in 3 modules. It's a program on which basically has a more tailored content and also has some special features which the undergrad program does not offer. We have already seen how these programs are located in the program of the Executive Academy, where you have this short program. So currently it's a short program. It's one of the longer short programs with 12 days in 3 modules. And then you can also upgrade this to an MBA program if you're interested in it. What we want to deliver in this program is basically we look for people from different parts in the organization, not necessarily only people with which come from the operative side, but also from the management level. And we want to teach them what we think is the new thing about data scientists, and what distinguishes a data scientist from the classical data analyst. For instance, one thing being the development of front-to-end solutions, methodological thinking and abstracting away or basically thinking in terms of which solutions, which methods and algorithms could be used to tackle certain problems. Whereas data analyst normally doesn't do that, but basically applies like approved analyzed processes. So what else we want to teach is that data science needs domain knowledge, and that we appreciate that people in the course program come from different backgrounds and different programs, and we actually encourage them to report mutually against about their data problems. And we have found this so far very fruitful, also the exchange with the students, and we learn from the students and with the students. So what else we want to do? We don't want to just teach what we think is a data scientist, but we also want to look ahead a bit. So what we think is there is more than just getting skills like methods and algorithms across, but we also want, as I said before already, as in the undergrad program, teach challenges with respect to legal regulations that have to be followed, ethical backgrounds, and so on, but also data governance. So what we eventually think of at the moment, like to expand this program, if you go for a full PMBA program, would be teaching also contents like data governance for companies, and maybe educating the CDO, right, Chief Data Officers, which is some new executive role, which is actually mentioned in several newspapers, magazines, as one of the new jobs around data and digitalization. Okay, so again, we have several institutes involved here. That is basically the same institutes that sat together and built up this program in the undergrad program, where we evolved, where we developed this new program. The new unique selling points of this is basically it's international, so it is also taught in English. It's targeted not only for Austria, of course, but for the whole European say market or internationally. We have faculty members teaching that, so if only I was teaching that, I could probably not get all the skills across that we want to get across. I learned a lot from my colleagues there as well. We have this project-based focus as well. We learn people to understand the whole data science process from front to end by working in projects in this lab. We had also support in the development for the program, I should say, from Internet Offensive Österreich. We can also offer tailored content for this program if you are interested in more details. So what I can say about the modules is we have these 3 times 4 days. In the first block, we give an overview of case studies. So we start with the application domains and we start with giving like an overview of use cases. For instance, from marketing and from supply chain management and from finance. And then teach them basic methods. And then basically at the end of module one, we catch that again and say basically, now this is how these methods can be applied in these projects or in these things you have seen in day one. So that's the idea to get together interest and make people think about how they can apply data science themselves in companies or in their own companies, where they come back now in module two, which starts now, with their own data science problems. So they all have to provide, coming into the module, a data science pitch, where they basically come with their own data problems. And then we will try to form groups out of these, and we have had a session already where we thought of how we can cluster these projects together. Maybe change slightly to another use case which is related to the one occurring in the company, and then basically make people work on projects which could really help them in the company. So that's the idea. What we then also teach is big data methods. We also have something called which we call Data Science Tools Fair. So we also have vendors there for one day. What do we have now? We have SAS, we have IBM, Oracle, and all the big vendors basically to argue why their tools are now data science tools or not. So they basically should tell us, and we put that up to discussion in the course with the participants. And then we conclude with more advanced methods than, from what we want. So then the rest of the course is still working on these projects. They also have to think about how legal and ethical issues play a role in their projects, or whether they have to follow certain regulations. And then basically in module three, we will basically provide them also with future trends and basically let them present their projects and basically further have some academic and industrial keynotes. So we will have, for instance, Michael Platzer there from Mostly AI, who also organized the AI Summit at VU, who will give a keynote there, and a colleague from Southampton, Elena Simpel, who will talk about data visualization and open data. So this is just in quick lectures which we have lined up. So Alfred Daudes, Thomas Reuterer, Andreas Mild, Ronald Hochreiter, Sabrina Kiran, Jürgen Umbrich, and Claudio Ciccio, who have all different backgrounds, like from process mining, data processing, working in security, statistics, supply chain management, marketing, and production management. And we also have tried to, which we also want to do in the next iteration of the course, to include public talks into the lecture program. Like one guest we had in the beginning of program one, as in talk in the evening before, was Professor Wim van der Alst, who is an expert in process mining and process management from, so he just moved actually to Germany from TU Eindhoven. And This was a really interesting talk. He talked, for instance, about FAIR data analytics methods, which basically would take into account fairness and ethical issues in the learning algorithms. And then I mentioned the other two already. So the whole course is, of course, and the whole all programs at EXAC are a kind of a methodological mix, which include knowledge transfer, discussions. So we basically involve the participants actively as far as we could. Should not only be a frontal teaching classes. We have teamwork in these courses as well. And I think that, so one of the things is that we take into account that we learn also from the participants and they learn from each other as well. So that's more or less all I wanted to say. The data science lab, in this course we have incorporated this idea as well. The main difference being that in the undergrad program we just get the companies and involved with company use cases to get the students to real life use cases. These people have real life problems already who come to the executive education, and we try to basically adopt their programs in a way that people can work in groups in these programs. Okay, that's essentially all I wanted to say. I could tell maybe more about the PMBA program, but I think all was mentioned already, so this is mainly that these programs can be extended towards a pre-MBA. That's what we want to achieve in the future. We want to basically evolve this to a full PMBA program, and I think this could be very interesting, and we also would appreciate any feedback of what you think, what could be missing, what could be still incorporated in such a program as you are practitioners, and I think you have quite some input on that as well. Okay, I think with that we could stop. Where are we time-wise?
After seven.
All yours.
Okay. So I guess we're ready for questions.
You haven't mentioned open source. How are you using open source?
Yeah, I mean we are using R and Python for we're using open source tools mainly in our education, but we also give a platform to commercial tools on one of the days, which is this industrial tools fair. We don't think that people in companies will only work with open source tools, but it's important that it's also a trend, which is good, that open source tools and are now more being used also in companies. For a couple of years ago, maybe nobody would have used R in companies, but now it came, I think maybe also from out of universities, that these tools are more used now in companies as well.
I'm teaching some mathematical technical things like simplex method or linear programming, non-linear programming, neuronal networks, and so on.
So we focus at the moment at statistics and machine learning methods, not so much on OR, but we could include this if there is a demand for it. So at the moment we don't teach OR methods concretely in the course. But could be an input.
I was just wondering, the graduation course for the executive academy, right, how long does it last?
So because, this program is right. 3 times 4 days, which is 12, so 12 days, 18 ECTS. Yeah?
Okay.
The PMBA is 30 ECTS, so respectively more coursework. You have to take some more modules from the regular MBA programs, which are established, but you can upgrade this to a PMBA.
Right. So it's more targeted to give the people an overview of the data science world, right?
This one.
Right.
Yes. So it's also to put people to get them to work. Also,
We
want people to understand and be able to solve data science projects themselves. It's not just giving them an overview on the management level.
Really?
They also have business projects and they have coaching on that.
Yeah.
So they're not alone.
Right, that's true. Yeah. So we provide between module 3 and we provide some coaching sessions for the groups. We do not expect that everybody will be a programmer who goes into this course, but we expect them to work in groups together and to understand what are the technical difficulties. So what we also want to create is like a mutual understanding with companies, what is involved in dealing with data and solving challenges about data quality, etc.
But you said 12 days, right?
12 taught days, like where they have to be in class. Of course, there are like pre-module and post-module assignments which people have to solve to come to the whole 18 ECTS. So one ECTS point is 25 hours of work, and if you count that together, obviously it's not only those 12 days in class which count for them.
Right, right. Okay.
So we expect some reading, we expect some preparation by the students and working together in the group project.
And most of your candidates are, or students are or where do they come from? Are they like,
we have a good mix of people now. So we have some people from companies, actually some from telecoms companies as well, some from public administration. We have also somebody from consulting who is more in geo information systems now. Yeah, it's a good mix. We are quite happy for this first run. About the mix of participants, we have also somebody from the agricultural sector. So it's actually that's what we wanted. We wanted to have people from different backgrounds, which we now hope to see the base from different angles, data problems, and then basically solve them together.
Right.
We have as well one person that is already since 20 years in this field of data science, but just wanted to have an academic upgrade on the knowledge, what is right now the most important things.
Mm-hmm.
And by the way, we also advertised in the first module for people to join in networks and communities, such meetups as you organize them here. I think this is a very important aspect of continuous lifelong learning on this on these matters. And so one of the meetup groups here in Vienna we suggested was actually yours.
The question was basically partially answered because I wanted to ask who your intended target audience is. Who are you trying to get into the classroom? Because on the one hand, it's of course in 12 days post and pre-os and Toulouse, but it's a very limited time frame.
Yeah, sure.
And so.
The reason why I've been just...
No, I mean, just one answer there. One obvious answer is that we do not want to or intend to replace a statistics undergrad program or a computer science undergrad program. We can't, right? So we want to actually play the strength that WU has, that we are close to the application domains of data science and give people the necessary background and tools to understand what they can do for their use cases.
And that was very interesting to me because I talked to all the people that were interested in our program, and we have one person that has a company of 200 people, and he said just that he's done with Excel sheets, he can't deal with it anymore. That's why he attended this course. And then we have a person that is already 20 years in this field, and he as well is like the most people feel like well with the course and are amazed and want to be testimonials for the course. That was amazing for me because I don't know how you do that, but they both feel like, okay, that's the right thing for them, so it's hard to say for whom it's special.
More questions?
What is the average age of your applicants? Participants?
I don't think we can disclose this for free.
Actually, the application is the most, they are above 30, 50?
Yeah, probably.
No, I think one is not even 30, so the range is also.
Yeah, I mean it's addressed to people to at the postgraduate level, so it would not be people who anyway would do a normal program at the undergraduate school.
Yeah, maybe one.
Yeah. One wild question, because I'm more to the practical side, but I also thought about what you do with data science and management, what you were more into. And I found the book Data Science for Business. It's number one on Amazon. So that's more for the management type. Do you know this book?
I have read it, but I have to look for business.
Okay.
Just a wild idea.
I mean, put some data science, whether it's really like No, but I mean, obviously, as you know, I mean, there are tons of books now mushrooming in the market about data science. So we try to also give our students their like a bit of a guidance at reading this, what we think is really worthwhile to read.
Yeah, this is more what you do with it, but management, you want to know about it, not the algorithms itself. So.
Yeah, but you have to know about limitations, right? I mean, not necessarily like every detail of each algorithm, but particularly. When you talk about limitations of learning algorithms, etc., what people expect now, the expectations are also partially over the top at the moment. And I think it's also an important role of education to basically relativize this and tell people what's really in this, right? So what's the pitfalls and what's the limitations. I say this particularly since I was trained in AI, and what people now use under the term AI is confusing me sometimes. Yes?
How do you find a lecturer for a program like yours?
Well, so the lecturers we have are faculty members of EU. We have, we teach those courses. We have courses in data science, as I said, in our study programs already. We have courses on digital marketing. We have courses on supply chain management, which all are getting more and more data driven, and basically the program was an opportunity for us to bundle all this expertise in one course program at the postgraduate level.
Yeah, regarding the question, regarding the application, you have stressed the application side of your course,
yeah.
And I was wondering, because at the University of Economy, at your economy, there is also an department, econometrics, Professor Crespo, maybe you know.
Yeah, I know the name. Yeah.
Yes,
so he's not yet in the program. Yeah,
yeah, clear, but this is also a very important
application
of
data. Colleagues, there is a new colleague, Ben Kleiner, who does data and strategy, so which also is about this topic a bit. And yeah, I'm thinking of also maybe involving this side of things as well,
okay.
If we expand the program. So this is the first iteration and first run of the program, which we actually, as I said, we aim to further develop. And if we expand it to a full PMBA program, which I hope we can eventually, then definitely we are looking forward to include this broader content as well. Yeah.
I find it very interesting that university is starting such a program for somebody with a mathematics background. That sounds like good news. But my question is, I'm curious because you're an AI expert in this area. Why did you launch a data science course and not an AI course? Which would perhaps like I mean, I understand you're some sort of target, not senior professionals, but middle management kind of type, who possibly will not be able to really do the coding and really do the analytics stuff, but want to understand what comes out of this for my business. And like
what
did
you teach in an AI course?
Yeah, it's a question I've been posing myself for a couple of months now. Mm-hmm. We also have two meetups here. We have like the data science meetup, there's a deep learning meetup, where there's a high degree of overlapping, but still it's not the same. And I was some sort of wondering, why you put an emphasis on data science is not more like on the algorithmic part of it.
Yeah, in principle, this is easily explained. So I think that almost all these businesses I showed you in the beginning were changed by data. Right? So it's more the availability of data, it's what you can do with it, that basically many companies are overwhelmed with the sheer amounts and possibilities they have by all these electronic traces and data. And I thought basically, maybe also from a marketing perspective, that basically calling the program, calling out data in the title is important. Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
And I like the term data science to sell this. I like it more than the term AI personally, because I think that the term AI is a bit missed, overused recently. So I come from more symbolic AI, and now everybody thinks AI is deep. So this is not the case, right? So AI has more to it. So in a way, this is to me like you would ask me, why don't you call this program computer science? Because it's not. It's data-driven economy. And doing data analytics and scientific approach to that, which I think is necessary because there are new challenges that cannot be overcome just by traditional methods. And that's how I see the term data science.
Okay.
So if you have a different approach to what our definitions, we have the first half day is about definitions of data science, but we would be interested in more of it.
No, I think that's fair. I understand your pitch. I personally, prefer the term AI because it's, I think it emphasizes more like the application side of it versus data.
Yeah.
But that's probably.
But then there's so much before, right? So for instance, what we teach in this data processing is how many things can go wrong before you can apply AI methods,
yeah,
before you can do data. And I think this is a huge part, and this is where probably what everybody of you is doing more than 50% of their work when they work on data science projects. And I think this we also have to get across.
Mm-hmm.
So we can't just start with the analytics and with the cool algorithms if we don't teach people also what are the challenges, but also what are the ethical and legal challenges of the game. So just my take on it. But of course, such a program would also be maybe interesting or more in terms of algorithms. We can, of course, not go into all detail there in a 12-day program. But that's more or less what we can offer, which we think so far meets the quite some demands. Yes. Okay.
Thanks a lot.
And thank you.